Oh, hello.
Hi, sorry, my mic wasn't on.
Hi.
My name is Sadia.
My name is Ahmed.
Whereabouts are you?
I'm from North Bay.
Oh, okay. Quite a ways away from me.
And I'm from Woodbridge, Ontario.
And I'm from Vancouver, BC, so on the other side of Canada.
Well, I'm in Saskatchewan.
I'm in Alberta.
Halifax.
If you had to pick a color to tell each other how you're feeling right now, which one would it be and why?
Straight up blue.
I would pick up the blue color.
Purple.
Light blue.
I'm like a really nice sandy beige.
Purple.
I'm gonna pick yellow.
I'd choose yellow. I'm in a pretty good mood.
Red.
Yellow.
Pick yellow.
Orange.
Yellow.
I was just gonna say the exact same thing. I love the color yellow.
Thank God you said that. I would have had to close the call. No, I'm kidding.
So what got you into mental health advocacy?
I started advocating in my high school. I don't know about you and your experience in the school system, but we never talked about mental health.
I have lost friends over it. I have lost a relationship over it.
Growing up in a community where mental health wasn't talked about.
Mental health, we don't talk about that.
When I was in grade 11, I made the terrifying decision to like go talk to my mom and be like, I would really like to start going to therapy.
Ethnic immigrant parents, mental health has been the hardest thing to talk about with them.
People in my community, there's no access to therapists. There's no access to peer support.
Do I pay for my MetroPass or do I pay for therapy? Do I pay for my textbook or do I pay for therapy? Yeah.
Lack of appropriate cultural resources.
We need to have more diversity in like top mental health positions, more diversity in psychiatrists.
And that's all I wanted growing up, was someone to stand up in front of my classroom and say, you know what, I hear you and I'm seeing you and I know what your experience is like, because I also go through that experience.
Jack was kind of like the first step.
One day I was walking down the hall and I saw the Jack.org booth for like my chapter.
This organization as a whole was like, it just pulled me in. Like there was no way I was not going to, so.
Again, the confidence came with doing more, getting more involved. And
it's really just been since then, and I wouldn't change it for anything, really.
So I'm really proud of that.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I mean, I'm proud of you for that.
Even as somebody who just met you, I'm proud of you for doing that. I think that like that takes a lot of guts to do the research, to get started, to connect to Jack.org, to figure out, you know, how am I gonna address this gap? And you really went after it, so that's great.
Oh my God, no, stop having me up.
So we need to have these conversations. We need to tell youth that they can make a difference in the world and that their mental health is important.
My yeah. goodness, snaps for you.
I think this show is like, for us right now, this is Undivided. Like we are coming from different places, different stories, different bodies, beautiful bodies. And we are here explaining and, you know, loving each other through words, through conversation.
So I think it's a matter of coming together and discussing what we can do to solve this problem and to make resources available to everyone who wants them and make them easily available as well.
We need to look at both our local communities as well as the community of Canada, because ultimately if we want change, we need to go full force.
Because like mental health can't move forward if one community is making progress and another isn't.
If we can't be here for everybody, we're really here for nobody, so.
And while there are definitely different needs for different communities, I believe that we are one.
Like there's an expression like divide and conquer, which like, yeah, it works, but also like if you unify and conquer, it might work a lot better.
100%, I love that.
Changing the cliche, love that.